I will be reading From a Jar of Dreams by Yoshiko Uchida. The Japanese-American author of this story, Yoshiko Uchida, was raised to appreciate her parents' culture and language, yet she was often excluded by her classmates as a result. Later, she traveled to Japan, and her appreciation for her heritage became stronger. When writing her novels, Yoshiko always emphasized the need for readers to look past labels and appreciate people as human beings. A Jar of Dreams. That summer turned special from the day Mama got the letter that caused her strange behavior. It was on a Tuesday. One of the days Mama went to work for Mrs. Phillips to clean her house and scrub her floors. The minute I got home from school and walked into the kitchen, I knew something was wrong. Well, not wrong exactly, but strange. I felt the way I do when I've got one sweater button in the wrong hole or when I put my left slipper on my right foot. In the first place, water was dripping from the kitchen faucet and splashing on dishes Mama had left in the sink. Ordinarily, Mama never leaves the house without checking the faucets to see that they're turned off good and tight. And she never leaves dirty dishes sitting in the sink when she goes to work. But that wasn't all. She'd left so many things scattered over the kitchen table, I couldn't even see the yellow oilcloth cover. The Japanese newspaper was spread out on the table with a square hole in it where Mama had cut out the recipe for the day. And she hadn't bothered to put away the scissors she'd used. There were two or three bills Mama hadn't opened and a five-page letter from Japan that hadn't been put back in its envelope. The table was a mess, and if I had left it that way, or my brother, Joji, we sure would have heard about it from Mama. I looked at the Japanese writing in the letter, squiggling up and down the soft rice paper like a lot of skinny black spiders, and wished I could read it. But of course I couldn't, because I don't study very hard at Japanese language school. And besides, I'm not far enough advanced to read that kind of writing. All I could read were the numbers that said first day of the fifth month, 1935. I had a hunch, though, that whatever was in the letter was the reason Mama had gone off acting like Yoji instead of her own neat self. And I couldn't bear to wait until she got home to tell me what was in the letter. I stuffed the letter in the envelope, grabbed an apple from the bin in the sun porch, and headed for Papa's barbershop. It was a hot day, but I ran all the way to Shattertuck Avenue and forgot to wait until I'd gotten to Channing Way before crossing Shattuck. That meant I'd have to walk by the Star Laundry, which I usually avoided like a nest of cobras because of Mr. Wilberg, J. Star, the owner. The reason I hate and despise Wilbur J. Starr is because he is so mean and nasty. Once, when I was in the fourth grade, Joji and I walked by his laundry on the way home from Papa's shop. Old Wilbur J. Starr was standing in the doorway of his laundry, and when Joji and I walked by minding our own business, he yelled, "Get out of here, you jack kids!" Joji dropped my hand and began to run. "Come on, Rinko," he yelled. "He's gonna get us." And he went steaming on ahead of me, pounding hard on his fat legs. I wanted to run with him, but when I heard Wilbur Starr laughing behind us, I just held up my head and said to Joshi, "Pretend you never heard him." But my knees were shaking so hard I could barely walk home. Ever since that day, I try never to walk by the Star Laundry if I can help it, because I hated the way I felt when Wilbur Starr called me a Jap. It made me really mad, but it also made me feel as though I was no good. I felt ashamed of who I was and wished I could shrink right down and disappear into the sidewalk. There are a few white girls in my class at school who made me feel that way too. They never call me Ching Chong Chiman or Jap the way some of the boys do, but they have other ways of being mean. They talk to each other, but they talk over and around and right through me like I was a pane of glass. And that makes me feel like a big nothing. Some days I feel so left out. I hate my black hair and my Japanese face. I hate having a name like Rinko Toshimura that nobody can pronounce or remember. And more than anything, I wish I could just be like everyone else. Later, Rinko finds out about the contents of the letter. Her Aunt Wonka in Japan was coming to visit them. During her stay, Aunt Wonka teaches Rinko to appreciate her Japanese culture and traditions, to preserve her heritage, and above all, to value herself.